Good afternoon, students. Today we are going to continue our chapter number 10, that is equation. We will start with practice set 27, question number 3. Now, practice set 27, question number 3 is, given below are some equation and some values of the variable. Are these values the solution to the corresponding equation? Now, in this, some questions has been given. Equations are given and the values, when we solve that equation, the values are given. So, we have to write whether that solution is yes or no. So, we will first solve it and then we will, as we get the answers, we will check the answer whichever is given in the table and then we will start writing if it is yes or no. Now, our first question is y minus 3 equal to 11. Where they have given the value of that solution, that means they got the answer y equal to 3. But we will solve it. Okay, our first question was y minus 3 equal to 11. They have given the values of that variable, that was y equal to 3. Now here I have explained you each and every operation of addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So how we are going to solve the first step? I told you whatever is the variable, after that, whatever number is there, that opposite number we are going to take on both the sides. So our first step should be y minus 3. Now minus 3 opposite is plus 3. Plus 3 equal to 11 plus 3. Now here in bracket what we will write? Adding 3 on both side. We have to write adding 3 on both side. This was our first step. Next, y as it is we will write, then minus plus. Minus plus is minus. So here 3 minus 3 will become 0. But the bigger number sign we have to put, that is plus. Equal to 11 plus 3. 11 plus 3 is 12, 13, 14. Equal to 40. Now here, what is y? Y we got 14. But they have given the values. They told the answers of y is equal to 3. Y is equal to 3. But we got answer as y equal to 14. So in the fourth column, solution yes or no. We have to write that it is no. Very good. So what we have to write? We have to write no. Wait a minute. So, in the first answer we got as no. Is it clear? You have to solve it in your rough book and then you have to write the answer, that is yes or no, in that column. Now, our second question is, we can see the second question. The second question is 17 equal to n plus 7. 17 equal to n plus 7. Now, here n equal to 10. Now they have given the value, that is n equal to 10. Now we can see the next one. Now we will solve here. Now what is the question? The question was 17 equal to n plus 7. Now I want answers from your side. Now what will be my first step? नाउ व्हाट इज द वेरिएबल, वेरिएबल इज एन, एन के साथ में क्या है प्लस सेवन, नाउ प्लस सेवन ऑपोजिट इज माइनस सेवन, सो ऑन द बोथ द साइड वी हैव टू राइट माइनस सेवन, सो हाउ वी विल राइट 17 माइनस सेवन इक्वल टू एन प्लस सेवन माइनस सेवन. सी आई टोल्ड द नंबर ऑपोजिट नंबर यू हैव टू राइट बोथ द साइड, सो हियर इट इज opposite, it is not given n plus 7 equal to 17. The question is given like 17 equal to n plus 7. So methods are same, only the way is given different. So first we have to write 17 minus 7 equal to n plus 7 minus 7. Now here, first 17 minus 7, 17 minus 7 we got as 10 equal to. Now here n will remain as it is plus, one thing we miss out, one thing we missed out for writing. I want the answers from your side. Write in the chat box what we missed out. Yes, student. Very good. Shravani, very good. What we missed out? We missed out the bracket one. We have to write subtracting 7 from both the side. Very good. Now Vedant also given the right answer. Now here we got 10 equal to n. Now plus minus will become minus. So 7 minus 7 is 0. But the bigger number sign is plus 0. So what we got? We got n as 10. So the value they have given was n equal to 10. So it is yes or no? It is yes. So here in the box, in that second box, what we have to write? We have to write yes. So what we will write? We will write in this box, in the second box, we will write yes. Is it clear? In the second box. And in the first box was no. The answer which they have given was wrong. So we have to write no. And then second box, we solved. We got the right answers. That means they have also given n equal to 10. And when we solved it, we also got n equal to 10. Now the next is third one. Now third one is 30 equal to 5x, where they have given the values of x equal to 6. Now we will solve here. Okay, now here 30 equal to 5x. Now I have explained you the operation also. Whenever there is addition, you have to make into subtraction. When there is subtraction, you have to make convert into addition. When there is multiplication, that will convert into division. And when there is division, it will convert into multiplication. Now in the third question, it is given 30 equal to 5x. Now this 5x is which operation? This 5x is which operation? It is very good, Arnav Ghag. It is the operation of multiplication. Now this multiplication will convert into yes, very good. This multiplication will convert into division. Very well. Now see the steps. Now the steps will not change here. Now I told whatever is the variable, the whatever is with the variable, the number should be the opposite. Now here it is 5x means 5 multiply by x. Now x ke saath kya kaun sa number hai 5, so that number will convert into division. So what you will take the number, the number must be 5. So here with 30 also you will divide 5, and with 5x also you will divide 5. Is it clear? See, I told the variable whatever is the alphabet, uske baju mein jo bhi number rahega uska hum log opposite karne ka. That means it is 5x, ye multiplication hai aur wahi number lena hai, so isko hum kya karenge, 5x ko hum lenge divide mein. So here 30 should also divided by 5 because variable ke sath 5 hai isliye, and 5x also should be divided by 5. Now here what we will write in the bracket, we will write dividing 5 on the both side. Now next is what we are going to do, the division. Now we will do a cutting. See, in 5 table 30 is coming. In 5 table, see, 5 ones are 5, and 5 how many times is 30? 5 how many times are 30? Very good. 5 6 is 30. So we will cut here, we will write here 6. 5 ones are 5, 5 6 are 30. Now here 5 ones are 5, 5 ones are 5. So what is remaining? X. X is remaining here, and here is remaining 6. So answer is 6 equal to X. So what they have given the values in the table, they have given X equal to 6, and we also got X equal to 6. So here the it is yes or no, it is yes. So in that table, in the third, fourth column, you will write S. Is it clear? See, it multiplication is got converted into division. So we have divided on the both the side by 5, and then we have done a cutting. After cutting, we got X equal to 6. Is it clear, students? Now we will do the fourth one, the last question. The last question is, see, the last question is M upon 2 equal to 14. Now here M upon 2 equal to 14. Now M is equal to 7. They have given the answer, the value, that means M equal to 7. Now we will find, is it right? Is it yes or no? Now here M upon 2, that means it is division. So this division will convert into multiplication. See, this division will convert into multiplication. M upon 2. Now M upon 2 equal to 14. Now this, how we will write? M upon 2 we will write as it is, multiply by 2 equal to 14 multiply by 2. Is it clear how you are going to write the division in the form of multiplication? M upon 2 you will write as it is. Upon kya hai? M ke saath. What is the number with that variable? The number is 2. So the 2 should be multiply on both the sides. So we will write here multiplying 2 on both the sides. Now here you can see the cutting also. 2 ones are 2, 2 ones are 2. What is remaining here? Only M is remaining. Now M equal to, now 14 twos are is what? 14 multiply by 2. Very good. 14 twos are is 28. Now M equal to 28. Now they have given the answer as M equal to 7. So is it yes or no? No, it is no. That means we got answer as m equal to 28, but they have given the answer as m equal to 7. So that is, the solution is wrong. That means no. So we will just see the table once again. Okay, we will see the table once again. The first answer was, what was our first answer? Very good. Our first answer was no. Then second was our yes. Second was our yes. What was our third answer? Third was also yes. And what was our last fourth answer? That was no. Very good. That was no. See, in your book, it is given only the table, but you have to solve it in your notebook, and the answer yes or no, that you have to write in your notebook. And answers, whatever we are getting, that you will write in the verb book. So here question number 3 also we have completed. Okay, now we are going to start with our next question, that is question number 4. Solve the following equation. Now this is also same as we done question number 3. Now here you have to solve it in your book, and then you will tell me the steps how you have solved it. I will unmute anyone student. From that I am going to ask how you have done the steps, because it is same as I taught you the third question. So our first question is question number 5. Now question number 5 is P upon 4 equal to 9. Now you are going to solve it in your book, and afterward I will unmute anyone and he will tell me, and then the steps I will write in my board. I'm giving you 2 minutes for doing that sum. After that I will call anyone. Your time has been started. Only 2 minutes for this sum. I hope you people are doing. Afterward, you will explain me the steps and I will write in the blackboard, and then we will match with the other student also. One minute is passed. Last 1 minute is remaining. I hope you people have completed. This is very easy sum. Complete it fast. If you have done, just raise your hand. Vaishnavi, I have unmuted you.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, Vaishnavi.
Yes. Can I tell?
Wait a minute, Vaishnavi.
Okay.
Yeah, you can start.
Yes, teacher. First, in the bracket, the P upon 4, there is the division. Then we have to convert it into a multiplication. So, in bracket, I have write multiplying 4 on the both side. Then I write P upon 4 multiply by 4 is equal to 9 multiply by 4. Then
wait, Vaishnavi, wait. I have to solve here, na? P upon 4 multiply by 4 equal to 9 multiply by 4. Okay. The next one. Vaishnavi, your voice is breaking.
Teacher, I have cut the 4 and write the 1.
Okay, yes, you have cut the 4 and you have written 1. Okay, so next one will be?
And the P is remain, so I have write down the P. And is equal to 9 multiplied by 4 is 36. So my answer has come P is equal to 36.
And where you have written the bracket 1?
After writing the P upon 4 multiplied by 4 is equal to 9 multiplied by 4.
First step, huh, nah? That is your first step after question.
Yes.
Yeah, what I should write here in that bracket?
Multiplying 4 on both sides.
Okay. Thank you, Vaishnavi. The sums you did was right.
Thank you.
I hope other student also done the same thing. That is P upon 4 multiply by 4 equal to 9 multiply by 4. That means P equal to 36. Okay, so we will move to the next sum. The same thing will happen with you people. You are going to solve it and I will unmute anyone to say the sum. Okay, now we will move to the next sum. See, the next question is M minus 5 equal to minus 12. This is the seventh number sum. M minus 5 equal to minus 12. So start solving. Student, just lower your hand. Two minutes is given for solving this sum also. If you have completed, you can raise your hand. Student, do it fast. Vignesh Naik, I have unmuted you. Vignesh Naik, I have unmuted you.
Teacher, I don't have finished yet.
Then why you have raised the hand?
By mistakenly.
Okay. Arnav Ghag, I have unmuted you.
Yes, teacher.
Okay, wait a minute. Let other finish. Wait a minute. Okay, Arnav, you can start.
Yes. So first I wrote M minus 5 plus 5 is equal to minus 12 plus 5.
Wait, Arnav,
in bracket.
Wait, Arnav, I have to write here, yes. Na? M minus 5 plus 5 equal to minus 12 plus 5.
Plus okay. 5. Then in bracket, I wrote adding 5 on both the sides.
Okay, adding. Yes.
Next. Then in downwards, I wrote M plus 0 is equal to minus 7. Then downward, I wrote M is equal to minus 7.
Very good. The sums you did, that is right. Okay, Arnav, you can mute yourself.
Yes.
See, other student, if you got the same answer, that is M equal to minus 7. Yes. See, I will explain these sums. You can see over here, the other student who has not completed. M minus 5 plus 5 equal to minus 12 plus 5. Now both the side we have taken adding 5 on both the sides. So here M minus plus will become minus. So 5 minus 5 we got 0. So M plus 0 equal to. Now you can see this equation, that is minus 12 plus 5. Now minus plus. Now I have explained you minus plus. Minus plus will become minus. Minus plus will become minus. So 12 minus 5. 12 mein se 5 gaya, so you will get answer as 7. Why I have taken the minus sign here? Because 12 number is the bigger number. So in front of that number, the sign is minus. So we have to take minus 7. So our final answer is M equal to minus 7. I hope you people have understood M equal to minus 7. Okay. So our next is wait a minute. Okay. Now this is the next sum. You people have to do it. That is P plus 4 equal to minus 1. Now you will do and you will write the answers in the chat box. The last P plus 4 equal to minus 1. I am given you 2 minutes only. Solve and give the answers in the chat box. Yes, some students they have done. Wait a minute. I am just going to explain it and then you will cross check whether you have done right or wrong. Let other student complete. Okay, time up. Now I will show you how the steps are there in this sum and you will cross check what with your sums. Now here P plus 4 equal to minus 1. Now P plus 4. Now here with the variable plus 4 is there. So I have to take minus 4 on both the sides. So here minus 4 equal to minus 1 minus 4. In bracket, I will write subtracting 4 on both the side. Now here P as it is, I will solve this one plus minus minus. So 4 minus 4 will become 0, but I should put a sign of addition, that is P plus 0 equal to. Now here in this equation, now here is minus, minus minus become plus, minus minus become plus. So 4 plus 1 will become 5, 4 plus 1 will become 5, but the bigger number sign is minus, so my answer sign should be of minus 5. So my final answer is P equal to minus 5. Now student, you can cross check with your steps. I hope you people, other people also done the same steps and answers they got will be of minus 7 only. So here our practice set 27, question number 4, we have completed. Next it is question number 5, that is of word problem. That word problem we will take tomorrow. So here we have completed our question number 4. See, next question is your word problem. Now we have only 5 minutes. We can't complete the word problem.